Hello everyone, our today's topic is Generative Answers in Copilot Studio. For all business needs, we need to define topics. And we may need to define hundreds of topics which require a lot of effort, time and human expertise. It is impossible to predict every kind of question that customer ask. So what is the solution of this problem? So we have power of Generative AI for rescue. Let's see benefit of Generative Answers in Copilot Studio. Before Generative AI, we have to define hundreds of topics, which require a lot of time, and we also miss opportunities. With the arrival of Generative AI, or we can say Generative Answers in Copilot Studio, we have to write less topics. So now with less efforts, and less domain expertise, we can handle more queries and grab more opportunities. Sometimes user asks a question that has no inbuilt topic. By default, Copilot prompts the user to rephrase the query. After two prompts, if Copilot still can't figure out user intent, Copilot escalate to live agent through system escalate topic. Let me show you. Let's create a simple Copilot without Generative AI. This is our simple Copilot without any Generative AI features. Let's refer one of topic lesson one over here. So these are phrases when you are closed, when you are open. Whenever user type these phrases, he will get answer like this. Let me test this one. Let me keep tracking on so I can follow along topics. Let me try a new phrase. As for this intent, there is no topic defined, so it moved to fallback. In first time, it's stating, I'm sorry, I'm not sure how to help with that, because in fallback, we have fallback count less than 3. In second time, I'll get the same response. At third time, it will move to escalate topic. So this is the behavior of a Copilot when there is no Generative AI features enabled. So let me show you how to enable Generative AI features in Copilot. As mentioned earlier, it is impossible to predict every kind of question customer asks, so we have to use boosted conversation. So what is boosted conversation? Let me describe you first. Let me show you boosted conversation in demonstration. When we create a new Copilot, like we have option over here to enter fallback website, or after creation we can define this in Generative AI menu. So let me go to same Copilot. I can define here. Let's take a fresh Copilot with Generative AI. Let me give website over here. At time of creation, you can only mention one fallback URL. But later in Generative AI menu, you can add up to 4 URLs. Click on create. You can see that this Copilot also have same topics as earlier, but when we use boosted conversation, it is also okay not to use any of the predefined topics. If I go to generative AI menu item. The website that we given at the time of creation of Copilot is visible over here. We can add more websites over here. In context of fallback URL, let me explain you a few important points first. We can use any URL, SharePoint, OneDrive, some kind of documents, and also custom data sources like Power Automate Flow. In this demonstration, I will focus only on Bing web search, but this is the overall generative AI process and considerations for you that I will cover in coming videos. Now let's talk about some URL considerations. Only two levels are allowed. Let's come back to our demo now. Let me keep tracking on. So you notice that for my intent, there was a predefined topic. Let me write a new query. Notice that answer came from fallback URL, which we had defined in generative AI section. Please also make sure this option should be enabled. If this option is disabled, the fallback URL cannot be used. Let me try this one. Let me try same query. Since we have disabled boosted conversation, if I enable it, after enabling, I get result from this fallback URL. So you can see that answer came from fallback URL, and we can see citation as well. Please see carefully, as for my intent, there was no predefined topic and our boosted conversation was enabled and we have provided fallback URL. So it called conversation boosting topic just before fallback topic. And also please notice create generative answers node. If you click on edit, you can see the name of the fallback URL that we given in generative AI menu section. If you want, you can also add more URLs from here. Let me try intent for there is no topic defined or there is no answer on fallback URL. For example, is tea hot? Yeah, because there is no topic defined for this and the answer is also not on the fallback URL, so it came to fallback topic. Let's also discuss one more aspect of generative answers. Click on generative AI. The website given over here is at Copilot level. Sometimes we want data source not at Copilot level but at topic level. So how to do that? Okay, let me create a new topic. Under advanced, you can see generative answers. This is the website of Visual Studio. So in this topic, simple topic, I manually called create generate answers. So we can define this generate answers node in any of the topic, and we can also define data sources. Please note that information sources defined in generative answer node override source you define at Copilot level. It means if this topic execute, this data source will be used instead of the Copilot level data source which you defined earlier. Let me save this one. Let's test. Notice that in this case, generative answer use the URL given in the simple topic instead of the URL given at the generative AI menu item level. If I click on citation, so it's referring different website. So we learned about generative answers basics, and also we learned about how to use fallback URL with generative answers. We'll talk more about OneDrive, SharePoint and other sources later on. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you liked it. I will be happy to solve your queries further. Please mention in comment box or refer my website, which I have given in description. Please subscribe to my channel to see such demonstrations. Thank you.